Hello everyone. Today, we're delving into the probabilistic Sharpe ratio, a key concept in analyzing and predicting the performance of trading strategies. Don't worry if it sounds complex. We're going to simplify and explain it step by step. Before diving into the probabilistic Sharpe ratio, let's quickly recap the Sharpe ratio itself. It's a measure of risk-adjusted return, calculated as the average return in excess of the risk-free rate, divided by the standard deviation of those returns. The higher the Sharpe ratio, the better the performance of the strategy relative to its risk. As you may recall from our last video, the Sharpe ratio is not a silver bullet solution and it does have its limitations. It's based on past data and assumes that returns follow a normal distribution, like heights of people in a city. But what if there's a basketball team in the city? Then the average height isn't very representative, right? Also, it does not account for the number of trials or tests that were performed to find the strategy. This is where the probabilistic Sharpe ratio comes in. The probabilistic Sharpe ratio, or PSR for short, is a statistic that measures the probability that the true Sharpe ratio of a strategy is greater than a given threshold. For example, if we set the threshold to 1, then the PSR tells us how likely it is that the strategy has a Sharpe ratio above 1. The PSR takes into account the historical returns and length of track record of the strategy, as well as the distribution of returns and the number of trials. When dealing with the Sharpe ratio, it addresses some inherent biases and errors. To calculate the PSR, we need to estimate four parameters. The estimated Sharpe ratio of the strategy, which we can obtain from historical data. The length of track record or number of observations of the strategy, which we can count from historical data. The skewness and kurtosis of the returns, which measure how asymmetric and fat-tailed they are compared to a normal distribution. The threshold or minimum acceptable Sharpe ratio for the strategy, which we can choose based on our preferences or benchmarks. Once we have these parameters, we can plug them into a formula that gives us the PSR. The formula is a bit complicated, but you can find it online or use Python libraries to calculate it for you. Let me give you an example of how to use the PSR. Suppose we have tested 1,000 strategies on a 10-year period, and we have found one strategy with an annualized Sharpe ratio of 2.5 and a PSR of 0.99. This means that there is a 99% chance that this strategy has a true Sharpe ratio above 0, which is our threshold in this case. However, if we calculate the PSR for this strategy using a higher threshold, such as 1 or 2, we may get lower values. For example, if we use a threshold of 2, we may get a PSR of 0.8. This means that there is only an 80% chance that this strategy has a true Sharpe ratio above 2. This shows us that the PSR depends on our choice of threshold and how confident we want to be in our strategy's performance. A higher threshold means a higher standard for success, but also a lower probability of achieving it. The PSR can help us compare different strategies and choose the ones that have a high probability of meeting our expectations. It can also help us avoid false positives or strategies that appear to be good but are actually lucky or overfitted. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you did, please like and subscribe for more videos on trading and finance topics. Thank you for watching and see you next time.